What's up, everybody? We are back here in Portal Knights. The Let's Play series continues. Sorry for the delay here. It's been a crazy hectic week. We have had a termite fumigation. So if anyone knows what that means, we had our big giant ass tent over our house. We had to evacuate for 3 days. And you'll notice that we have successfully gotten the iron ore that we needed. We've upgraded our weapons. Our skill bar down here has quite a few different weapons. You can see we got this fire wand now, which throws out tons and tons of fireballs at rapid fire. Then we have this ice staff, which throws out a big chunky ice ball. So there's a weakness and resistance in this game, and we are currently on like around level 13 or 14, and this is an ice stage, so the fire staff is extremely powerful in this stage here. I'll show you the map here. What we've done is we've went through these mushroom stages, level 11, level 12, etc., looking for iron ore, and iron ore is a rarish material here. I mean, there's not much iron ore. It's in these mushroom-like stages, and it's a bitch to mine. Really, really is. You need a lot of it. We don't even have, you know, enough iron ore yet. We still need more and more and more iron ore, but we're just going to progress with the game a little bit here, show off the new stage, because quite frankly, mining iron ore for 2 hours at a time is extremely boring, and I don't think you want to see me mine iron ore for 2 hours at a time. So, we are killing these skeletons here, and this leads us to the next step, that in order to upgrade your gears, your armor, and your weapon, you had to get these ice items. And you see, this is an ice stage, but the ice guys only appear at night. So these frost dudes, the Hollow Knight of Frost, since the fire is very effective, they drops these frost sapphire dust and raw frost sapphire. These things are required for weapons and armor, and you need quite a bit of them. You can only farm them, I found so far, at night. Ugh. In this stage right now. We haven't gotten any further than this, so we've just been farming these guys here. Definitely wanted to let you guys know, you do want to make sure that you pick up the fire rod, because as you can see, the fire rod is very effective against those ice guys. When it's very effective, it does appearing double damage. So you're able to knock down those guys really quick. Allows you to farm way more effectively. And I am just blown away. We posted a video of some screenshots on the Portal Knights Facebook page. They've been featuring a lot of screenshots of cool custom things that have been built, or just cool picks that have been created in the game. Ugh. And there's so many amazing things that you guys are creating out there. If you haven't seen them, head over to Facebook, Portal Knights. And just check out the amazing items that have been created so far. There's so many awesome houses and castles. Amazing screenshots of monsters and the lighting effects. People are just so creative, like, it's mind-blowing. I don't have a creative bone in my body, so we are gonna try and design like a house like this and be happy with it, be like, yay, we made a house. So this is all this is generated by the game, but yeah, this is be like what I would attempt to do. I would attempt to like make a house like this and maybe make it like a double-decker house and go from there. Like, we haven't even finished building our initial house in the very first stage. I don't think we have a roof yet, guys. And you got these people that have built massive castles. We're also potentially looking for like the best area to build in. And we've seen some really cool levels and scenery. I saw this ice castle or ice house that looked really, really cool. Another thing that I want to attempt is, I'm sure someone's probably mined every single brick off of a level and see, you know, if that's even possible. If you can destroy a level completely, take every single one of these bricks and destroy it, that would be pretty cool. And then I wonder what the amount of bricks, blocks, that you could put in a level. Because obviously, you destroy all the bricks, you're going to put them in your backpack. You won't be able to carry all of them unless you have tons and tons of storage chests. But I wonder how many blocks that you can actually put in different levels. There has to be some kind of limit. Some kind of system limit. Have any of you guys reached that limit? Post it down in the comment section. Let us know. Looks like we have finished up this stage here. Let's head on out. Recording. So we're gonna head on out here. See if we have enough. Yep, we have enough. Brand new stage, guys. First look. What will it look like? Somber embers, it looked like. Somber Evergar lanes. Okay, so nothing really special. This is kind of cool. It's got a cave already built in it. Oh, and we have a bat. Thunder. Yeah, so I know some people have already definitely crushed through the game. We like to enjoy and explore. Exploration, I think, is the key of this kind of a game. Sadly, there doesn't appear to be many hidden treasures or hidden goodies out there, but you can definitely see amazing little things. Caves and find, you know, monsters and spawn locations. And who knows, maybe there might be just some hidden relic out there waiting for some brave explorer like ourselves to, you know, go and find. So we're back in a mushroom area, which means we should probably be able to get some more iron ore. These guys are very annoying. They have tons of evasion, and you miss them all the time. Three ice balls and like two of them missed. Not fun at all. Let's go and heal up on fire wand there. So if you remember last time we were hunting for iron ore, so I think I see some over there. We're gonna do a little bit of mining here, because quite frankly we still need a lot of iron ore. And we still haven't found like a gold mine of iron ore yet. It's still a very rare material. Kaboom! Level 16! Stats up. So we did find one little monster. That dropped iron ore, but when he drops it, he only drops one piece at a time, so it's definitely a lot easier to go and mine. You can see it only takes a few clicks. Ah! Oh, we survived! We got so close to just jumping to our death. Alright, we need some bricks. Wow, we don't like even have much. Alright, let's put that there. Probably not gonna use that guy. Don't need that. So Enrage is a cool spell, gives you more damage. And then we have the zap right there. Let's put that over here. Do a strong healing potion. Alright, let's build our way a staircase up here. Like, iron ore, it appears, in only, like, small bunches. Like, this is, like, 4 pieces of iron ore. Maybe, like, 2 or 3. A very, very small bunch of iron ore. And you need, like, 10+ to make the bricks and things like that. It's a very, very, small amount. So I think they definitely want to probably change that. It's quite annoying having to mine tons and tons of iron ore, and we're only, you know, a few levels into the game. We're only around level stage 16 or so right now, 17 maybe. So about, not, you know, about halfway there to the end of this world, and we're already getting to it, like, annoying factor of iron ore. The other annoying factor that we've run across is the bag space is very, very limited. I guess there's a way around that, a walk. Or, a way around it is to take storage chests and bring storage chests with you and then drop them down in each of the levels. I want to say there's even an achievement for doing something similar to like that, of putting, a workbench or a storage chest on every single island. So definitely some annoyances creeping in there. Oh, we got jacked. They are taking player feedback and posting them on forums. So if you have complaints, concerns, you want things changed, post them on the official forums, PortalKnights.com. The developers are doing about a weekly update, letting us know where they're at in their cycle of what they're looking at, what they're thinking, how early access is going, their plans for the future, and it appeared that there's going to be about updates. I think it was about once every month that they're going to do kind of like a major-ish update, a content update. Of course, there's going to be a lot of bug fixes, as right now, some of the achievements are not working. I believe they fixed the whack-a-mole achievement. So if you had trouble getting that whack-a-mole achievement, now it should work. I know something that I do think that they should implement is the exploration system of finding treasure chests and finding like heart pieces, like in The Legend of Zelda. Being able to go out and search the world to find more HP would be a definite plus, and then also be able to find more bag space. You should be able to find special things like that, things that aren't required to play the game, but would just be a nice quality of life achievement. I don't know if there's any way to dodge that lightning zap bug thing. Did a lot of damage. So those are two big things that I'm suggesting to them, is more exploration items like hidden treasure chests or just hidden things, being able to find hearts out in the world. You know, if anyone's played The Legend of Zelda, any of the games, you go around and you collect heart pieces, you build up your HP gauge, your heart gauge. It's a really effective system. And also would be a nice way to pay homage to The Legend of Zelda, as this game is very reminiscent of that series. Do a lot more damage. You can see it's huge DPS different, and especially when you combine it with this fire wand, Enrage is a really powerful spell. Our nemesis. Nice, no line of sight. And they are working on better AI as well. As you can see, it gets stuck very easily. So these things are in the works. Mushroom. They've also heard the feedback that a lot of players are saying that the difficulty needs to be turned up a notch. I do agree, it would be nice to have a more challenging mode, at least. So have your casual mode like this, for beginners or for noobs like me that just, you know, suck. Nah, I'm just messing. But yeah, for having a more casual friendly mode and then more a hardcore extreme mode. I've also proposed that they implement, you know, like an auction house system, something so you're connected to other players, and that way, if they do the hard mode of monsters and stages, they don't have to change the worlds at all. They could just redo the same world, but make the monsters hit a lot harder, make them like twice as fast, and then give them better drops, or different drops that we haven't seen yet, and in order to encourage, you know, risk versus reward, we can then have an auction house type system where you could sell those goods to a player that just kind of wants to create and do, you know, fun, easy stuff, not as competitive PvE wise. So there would need to be some kind of currency, some kind of like either like coins or something like that. I think that's where the game should go. But they are taking different suggestions and feedbacks, and they said they don't want it to be an MMO, or don't want that MMO, you know, RPG tag right now. But I think that's definitely the way that they should go. So they are looking for other players' feedbacks as well. If you think that's the direction that the game should take, post it on the forums. The more people that post that, the more likely it will happen. What's down here? So it'd be so cool to just like kind of have a purpose of digging through a cave like this and finding some hidden treasure, finding a heart piece, finding, you know, a bag slot, finding something down here. So it's just throwing ice cubes and having fun for throwing ice cubes. But we find the edge of the world, which we find quite often. We did find one little piece of ore, but see, like, it'd be so much rewarding if you actually found something special, something that's, you know, insanely rare or actually really, really useful. So finding one piece of ore doesn't really do much for us. We're gonna go mine it because, you know, why not? We're here. It's one piece of ore. But yeah, I'm still holding out hope and dreaming that that's something that comes into this game. Because to me, it is really about exploration. Again, I know a lot of people are into the creative stuff, so I know there's been a lot of talk about like a builder's mode or a free mode similar to what Minecraft has. And I'm pretty sure that that's going to get implemented into the game. Because a lot of people have been asking for it, and it's a good idea. Ugh. There. And then they also touched upon enhancements to the current skill tree. As you can see, it is incredibly bare. Only one choice in most of the skills. This is definitely going to get an overhaul. This is going to get dramatically improved in the coming months. This is something that they definitely do want to enhance right there. It's nighttime, those damn ghost things. See, that's a pretty dangerous spot. You got four enemies. You probably don't want to jump down there. Because you'd probably meet your death against those guys. And especially if the monsters were, you know, two times faster. It'd be an insane battle down there. Let's see if we can find a portal and get the F out of here. There it is, the portal! Safe. The other thing that would be awesome too, Platinum Hills, if they didn't have this map that showed you there how many portals there are in that world. Having random portals or mysterious portals that would open up and take you to different worlds. That would be really cool, rather than being able to come up and look at a map and just say, okay, I know there's two portals here. One goes this way, one goes that way. Let's find both of the portals. And I apologize for the dog there. It looks like we actually went back a stage. Ugh. Recording things, stop. Stuck. Yeah, whenever the screen shifts like that, that's due to the fact that the recording, the cursor is trying to actually like click on the pause button or something like that in the recording. It's brutal, man. I can't do anything. No, this is a different stage. So it's another ice stage. Aspects of the game is the music too. The music is really nice. a lot of the times I don't even listen to the actual game music, but the soundtrack in this game is actually like soothing and fits pretty much perfectly to the game, and it adds a lot to the experience. It's hard. Right. Potion. Oh, turn to night, so we have some easy kills now. Highly recommended. Ice Day, just bring some fire weapons, guys. Makes your life so much easier. Oh! Mini dragon bomber. It's the first time that we've seen that little thing, I think. So once again, yes, I do want to play with you guys. We do want to do multiplayer co-ops. It just, no one has been online when I've been streaming, video recording, whatever you want to call it. So you can add me on Steam. It's YouTube Jason Wyvard, all one word. Back at the beginning here, this is the castle. It's kind of cool here what they did. Cages, and they have like a little loft. So good to yourself, it alerts you to enemies, you can hear them, so you gotta use all your senses. So I might just build my castle in this like ice level, because I love the look of these trees with the snow on them. It's very Christmassy. Take out all these other crappy bear trees, just keep these nice snow Christmassy fir trees. So those frost guys don't appear to be dangerous at all, and we're getting to a new portal here, guys. So this looks to be like the boss portal that is using a green stone now. So we have yet to find any green shards at all yet. We have to go on the hunt for the green shards. You can see the color is now green. Have to figure out which creatures drop those green shards so we can get to the next boss. Last time it was these giant things. So let's take a look. This guy right here. I want to say he might actually drop iron. Yep, he drops iron. And he drops a green portal shard, guys. We figured it out. Yes! So you're going to be farming that giant dude. Ush! And that electric ball stays there. You can see the electric ball is still there. So we're defending a lot of those big dudes. And that'll be a nice way to farm some iron too. If we can find a ton of those guys. I think there's two different ports here. Yeah, there's two different ports. So if we can find this one, it should take yellow shards. And maybe we'll find some more of those giant dudes. So it looks like we're going to have to actually dig. It looks like we're going to have to do some exploring, guys, to find that other portal. Because we've walked, I believe, the entire top layer. And we've yet to see that portal. So it looks like it's going to be underground somewhere. See if we can avoid all the monsters, get a nice aerial view until we fall off to our death. Now, there's no fall damage in this game, guys, if you're just joining us. This is Portal Knights. Sandbox game. You can create, you can mine. Similar to Minecraft with a Legend of Zelda feel to it. Is that a big guy over there? Alright, there's a giant dude right there. There's a giant dude over there. You don't see any portal, so let's go attack the giant dudes. Giant dude. Whoa, Geronimo! Portal shots. Iron ore. And there's the other big dude that we saw from above. Oh wow, so he throws up lightning up in the sky that comes down and rains on your parade. So let's dig, guys. This other portal has to be somewhere down underground. They actually do enough damage to kill the dirt, and they mine pretty effectively. down the starting cave. Let's go over here. What the heck is that? Ah, it's our death! Oh, we got a nice bottom view of the town there, the island. Oops, my bad. Maybe if we mine. We found the boss, or the minion boss. Poor shark dude. Go crazy, mage! Alright, so we've checked there, we've dug holes. Maybe down here. Definitely don't want to stand there. Alright, nothing there. Oh, we're stuck. This is actually quite cool, guys. I'm really excited to find this portal. I think this is the first time that we've been kind of like, not stumped, but we actually had to really look for a portal. Level 17. Ooh, those guys. I think he dropped green portal shards too. Oh, luck. Let's see if the mini dragon gives us green guys again. Nope. I think we passed over this. Sapphires. Yeah, we built right over it. This is trying to tell us to dig underneath here. Oh, we're getting attacked from three different directions! Nice, so they have the chance to drop the green portal shards. Alright, so I think there's going to be something down here. You can see we got these different kind of bricks. So let's go ahead and dig. Make our way in here. It looks to be like a cave, maybe. Yeah, it's dark. It's gloomy. Yes! We found the secret cave. We did it, guys! We did it! Alright, so that looks like... That's just like, mind me! Place like that, it's asking to be mine. There's nothing there. Oh yeah, we have level up stat increase. Really, there's nothing here. That was just like totally mind me thing. Right. Let's keep going. Yep, some more green shards. Also drop some copper ore, which is nice. They drop the ore that you don't have to go mine anymore. If only they could drop iron ore. So, the reason we're mining this over here is it looked kind of funny. It had a little design on it. I'm just curious about what potentially could be here. Most likely there's going to be nothing, guys. But I'm a curious cat. Yeah, it doesn't look like anything. Kamikaze bombers. Oh yeah, they are kamikaze bombers. Oh, look at that dodge, the jukes. We got moves, guys.
Treasure chest!
Really? The wand doesn't want to attack the treasure chest? Wow, iron ore, guys. We got one iron ore. Ooh, what is this? What is this? We trash something. Silk. Alright, so the wand wanted to attack up there. So let's dig a little and see what the heck is up there. Might be right below some monster that the wand was trying to target. Door here. We found something. Yeah, we see something. So this is just a way up to the floor that we were just at before. Alright, so that's just right above us. So we're going deeper and deeper into this cave. We're trying to find the portal. Treasure chests! Wow, no portal. These are dead ends now. Green shard. Iron plate block. Scroll of healing. Wow, okay, so what do we do now? Where's the portal at? We can blow up this wall over here. Back up. I'm trying to see where this leads us. on top of the world. So this is gonna obviously lead us out. Oh, and it leads us out to the death. All right, so we know there's nothing over in that direction. Now we gotta look for the portal again, guys. We are almost at a loss here. Where could this portal be? Make sure I'm not going blind here. So I think maybe... Okay, I think maybe this is only a portal to here. You see how it's not lit up? I think that's probably why... I think this portal goes to here. That's what I'm assuming. Yeah, it's a solid line. Alright, so I don't think there's a portal. I don't think we're crazy, guys! Let's see how much we need. So let's head back home, drop the stuff off, take a look at home sweet home, come back here and say hello to the boss. See, home sweet home. We haven't even finished the roof. Alright, we definitely picked up some scales. So I highly recommend kind of having an organization system, because even the larger chest doesn't really hold much more items than these smaller chests. So you can see those are the smaller chests. And this is the larger chest here, so it's got a little bit more inventory slots. Not much. And there goes my organization skills. No idea what we're throwing in there. We're just throwing random stuff in there. Oh, it doesn't show the little X thing anymore. Alright, so this one is organized. We got all our potion thingies here. Scroll there. And this one is all blocks. We have a lot of storage chests. Alright, so for the boss, we might need some healing. Regular healing. We got some healing. We got strong healing. Okay, let's bring that. Yeah, I think we should be good with strong healing potions. Oh, they're only stacking 5? That's lame! Alright, so we're back. We got some healing potions. Ah, and the skeleton! So it looks like the green shards now are appearing a lot since we're level 17. So there may be a level requirement to fight the boss. Because before, we weren't really getting any green shards, and we fought a lot of these guys in this stage. Getting attacked from left and right. Let's get out of here and take our first look at the boss. So again, thanks for watching, guys. We're going to go and take a look at the boss of the Dragon's Lair. See if we can slaughter this beast. Alright, so he is apparently a dragon, which means probably going to be a fire dragon. So let's do some ice damage, and what is this? Is that like his egg? We have to hatch him? Alright, so let's make this platform a little bit bigger. It's not letting me build? I can't build? Aww. Sadly, we can't cheat and build. Alright, guys, so let's attack that egg. And there is the dragon! And he is immune. Alright, so what technique do we have to use? Oh, we're probably gonna shoot the egg into his mouth. Yeah, that's what I would assume. Shoot the egg into his mouth is what I'm guessing here. Yep, damage brings him down. Ice is strong against him as we anticipated. Look at that damage. The DPS is insane. Oh, and now his little minion egg things have hatched. Oh, we got wasted. Oh, he's gonna go down here. We're enraged. Oh, no, he did not go down. The enraged didn't really do much damage. But we got wasted there. So we're trying to get rid of the eggs that we don't need. And then by luck, we'll hit him like that. So it looks like he goes around in circles. Gonna use a potion. Now it looks like he is gonna go. So So those little guys, they give... they give hearts. So if you don't have potions or healing stuff, you can go kill those little guys. He's not doing a pattern anymore of going, ah, those things are very effective against me. Nice. Got him, and now we're gonna take- Oh! Did we just double killed? I think we just got double KO'd. He spewed out things. Did we get the victory, or do we have to fight him again? Oh, we have to fight him again. Faster rod. Yeah, I think the faster rod here will help waste these things. And then we'll switch over to our ice rod. So close. So I wonder if it's a pattern of 1-1-3, 1-1-3, and his fireballs. Yeah, so this is his second. This should be a 3 now. Yep, 1-1-3, 1-1-3, I think is the pattern for the fireballs. Egg hatched way down below. Oh, it ricocheted off that thing? It took a hit. And so the next one's gonna be a 3. Center here so he doesn't throw it as far. He's throwing them all off. Alright, so we are down. Oh, and I think we got him! Is he gonna throw out his fire again? Alright! Victory!
Oh, that was a pretty cool battle, guys. Thanks for watching. Unlock the dragon achievements.
And get to Heatwave Hills. Join us next time as we explore Heatwave Hills. Oh, this is awesome. Oh, this is crazy. Oh, man, I think I want to live here. This is so cool, volcano looking. Man. Heatwave Hills, coming soon in the Let's Play series. Again, thanks for watching, guys. Hit that like, share, subscribe to the channel to see more Portal Knights. And I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out.